So a question from syllogisms, we have got only two statements with six conclusions, right? Two statements and six conclusions. So let's try it out. Some answers are bad. Some answers are bad. Draw the basic diagram, right? Some answers are bad. Some answers are bad. And some bad are correct. Some bad are correct. I think that's the basic diagram. A, B, C. Some answers are bad. Some bad are correct. You know what is the basic diagram, right? The one which involves minimum encroachment, minimum overlapping. So some answers are bad. Some bad are correct. Now, some bad are answers. I think we don't need to do check a diagram for this one, right? If some A's are B's, the definite conclusion is some B's are A's. Some, I mean, A and B not in this context, but in general. Or let's say some X are Y's. That implies some Y's are X. I mean, it's always true. The definite conclusion for some X's are Y's is that some Y's are X's. So some answers are bad would mean some bad are answers. You don't have to even check a diagram for that. Similarly, I think the second one, some bad are correct, so some correct are bad. Some bad are correct, obviously some correct are bad. Yeah? Again, no need to check the diagram for that. Some answers are correct. Some answers are correct? No. In the basic diagram itself, it fails. Some answers are correct, fails. So some answers are correct is wrong. Some answers are not correct. Well, it satisfies the basic diagram. Some answers are not correct. We can always choose some of these answers and say these are not correct. But will it always satisfy? No. My practice of solving questions on syllogism tells me that some answers are not correct would be false. I'll tell you how. Let me draw a possible diagram to prove it false. Some answers are not correct. See, can you draw the diagram in this way? It says some answers are bad. I can say answers and bad are equal. And some bad are correct. I can say bad and correct are also equal. I can only use one circle, one set to represent all the answers and bads and corrects. So some answers are bad, some bads are correct. Yes or no? This is a possible way of drawing it. Now, if you consider this as the diagram, tell me, is this true or false? Some answers are not correct. Which answers are not correct? All the answers are correct. All the answers are correct. So how can you say some answers are not correct? Right? So fourth one becomes false. Fourth one becomes false. Now, some bad are not correct. Some bad are not correct. Again, some bad are not correct fails in the same possible diagram. Right? See, remember, some bad are correct does not mean that some bad are not correct. Be very careful. Some X's are Y's does not mean that some X's are not Y's. Don't go with that inclination, right? Some X's are not Y's. Right? Some A's are B's does not mean that some A's are not B's. So don't even draw the diagram to check this. If some bad are correct, then some bad are not correct is not correct. I mean, this sounds like a tongue twister, but the point is, if some beds are couches, does not mean that some beds are not couches. You understand? Then some answers are not bad. Again, I think the one single possible diagram proves all the last four ones to be wrong, right? This one. Some answers are not correct. Where? Some bad are not correct. Where? Some answers are not bad. Where? All three of them are equal. Right? So I think the answer to this question should be only 1 and 2 follow. Only 1 and 2 are correct. Only 1 and 2 are correct. Right? Now I'm sure a lot of you will be confused with the point that some answers are correct and some answers are not correct is a complementary pair, which is absolute nonsense. Similarly, some bad are answers and some bad are not answers are complementary pair, are making complementary pair. Absolute nonsense. Or some correct are bad and some bad are not correct are complementary pair. No. Remember, some A's are B's and some A's are not B's is not a complementary pair. I have mentioned this multiple times. I'll mention it once again and highlight that in red. Some X's are Y's and some X's are not Y's. Is not a complementary pair. Very, very important point. Very, very important point, because I've seen a lot of you getting confused with this one. Some A's are B's and some A's are not B's is not a complementary pair. Very, very important. Some A's are B's and some A's are not B's. It sounds like a complementary pair, but it is actually not. Some A's are B's and some A's are not B's is not a complementary pair. So don't consider some answers are correct and some answers are not correct to be a complementary pair. Similarly, some correct are bad and some bad are not correct to be a complementary pair. Those are not complementary pairs, right? There are only two complementary pairs when it comes to syllogisms. Some A's are B's and no A is B is one complementary pair. And then the other one is all A's are B's and some A's are not B's.